If you're a fan of Melee, you might be familiar with a technique called scar jumping. In Smash 4, there's a similar technique, however, since you can only wall jump once before you touch the ledger stage again, it's really just a single instant wall jump. To perform an instant wall jump, point the control stick away from the ledge, then towards the stage, and then back again away from the ledge. Simple. The catch is that you need the smallest and most precise movements to wall jump at the earliest possible frame, or close to it. Here's how it's done. As you can see, you hardly need to move your thumb from the neutral position before bringing it back in the opposite direction and vice versa. The timing is tight, but it's definitely one of the easier techniques in the Smash library. The lucky characters who can wall cling can also instant wall cling. The only difference is after jumping off of the wall, you can double jump, cling back on, and get a second wall jump out of your cling. Despite being a little flashy, both of these techniques can be extremely useful for edgeguarding and getting back on stage. Instant wall jumps and clings send you high enough in most cases to use two aerials and then double jump to recover, so mixing up your edgeguard strategies with these two techniques is not a bad idea at all. If an opponent is on stage trying to stop you from recovering, you can instant wall jump and then double jump to get back on stage with an attack. This is perfect for when your invincibility frames are about to run out and you know you're gonna get down smashed at the ledge. There's another technique in Smash 4 that also uses the walls, but it's specific to Ness, and it definitely helps his recovery a lot. If you PK Thunder into a wall and bounce off, you have about a second or 60 frames where you can PK Thunder again and save yourself. This technique was discovered shortly after the 3DS version came out, but the two videos I found online of it didn't have many views at all, so I thought I'd showcase it again. Ness really benefits from the double PK Thunder on square stages like Duck Hunt, Wrecking Crew, and Wily's Castle, but it doesn't really work on the flat platform Omega stages or the ones shaped like Smashville. If you bounce off of the bottom of a stage, you won't have any room to use your double PK Thunder. Battlefield and Final Destination can be tricky for this technique, but it is possible to pull it off if you can bounce at the right angle. There are also sweet spots on the stages shaped like Smashville that you can hit and snap to the ledge without even needing a second PK Thunder. Make sure you keep this technique in mind and choose stages accordingly whenever you or your opponent is playing Ness. And if you play a character with a real wall jump or cling, mix up your edge guarding and recovery with some instant wall jumps to surprise your opponents. If you're craving more tutorial type videos, check out my series called How to Smash, where I break down the core elements of Smash that apply to every game in the series. Just click the video on your screen. Or if you want to see me tackle some Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, head on over to youtube.com/consolecreatures for my Let's Play series. All the links you need are in the info section below. I'm EMG Smash Central, thanks for watching, and happy smashing!